Okay, well, this video should already be made, be prepared, be ready to go, but I had so many problems with the camera, and I spent about an hour trying to figure out the camera, so this video is going to go up a day late. It's so annoying. This is so annoying to sit, and technology just never works when you want it to, and when you don't want it to work, it's like, I'm going to be the fastest thing in the world. So annoying, man. This is killer. This is really killer. So, what we're doing today, we're going to go through all 14 teams in the playoffs. We're going to do a rankings. Yeah. It's been a day for me already. It has been a day, and I am just... I'm done. I am so done. We'll start with the Bills. I just kind of threw them all in here. Bills, to me, are Super Bowl contenders. I think they can beat anyone in the AFC. And I think they can get as far as they want. If they don't want to play and show up and not show up, then they're going to get eliminated. But if they want to play, if they want to show up, they can beat the Bengals. They can beat the Chiefs. They can beat the Eagles. They can beat the Niners. They can beat anyone. So, yeah. Yeah. Super Bowl bound. We're going to throw up the Niners up here, too. They just feel like a team, a defense that can literally hang with anyone. The offense, again, has weapons. Brock Purdy is looking actually pretty good. Do not be shocked if the Niners make the Super Bowl, because how everything is right now, they feel like the team that's going to. This team feels like it's going to beat the Eagles. It's going to beat the Bucks. It's going to beat the Vikings. It's going to beat the Cowboys. It's going to beat and kill Seattle. So, yeah. It feels like they're a team that can beat literally anyone in the NFC. But the NFC is so bad that it's like, okay, well, I wouldn't be surprised if the Niners win, because the Seahawks are terrible, the Cowboys are terrible, the Bucks are terrible. The Vikings literally don't deserve to be in the Super Bowl, like, at all, because they're getting killed, and, you know, you don't face the Colts every week. So, you know, you're not, the Vikings are, like, they're, like, in between here. They're either first-round exits, or they might make it to, like, the divisional round, and depending on their luck, they might get to the NFC Championship game, but the Niners are just going to kill them in the NFC Championship game. And they have to go to the Niners, because the Niners, I believe, are the second seed. So, yeah, it's just that they can make a playoff run, or they can just be a first-round exit and lose to the Giants. That's how it is. So, Seattle, real quick. I know we're kind of going NFC here real quick, but it's just I want to get these teams out of the way, because Seattle doesn't deserve to be in the playoffs. The Packers didn't deserve to be in the playoffs. The Lions, I don't think, would have beaten the Niners. I don't really think that... Like, I had them, their ceiling, to me, was the wild card round for the Lions. And I don't think anyone beats the Niners. I think the Eagles are going to give them a shot. But I think that this is... Like, the Eagles are going to be underdogs to the Niners, and they're going to be at home. If we get an Eagles and Niners NFC Championship game, Eagles are going to be at home, and everyone's going to be like, oh, well, the Niners are going to win, just because look at that defense. Like, they can kill anyone. They can stop anyone. They're going to stop that run game. They're going to stop that passing game, and Brock Purdy's going to come out, go, here you go, George Kittle, throw a 5-yard in route. Here you go, D-ball. Here, take the ball and go ahead and run for 75 yards for a touchdown. You know, Ayuk, oh, here's a little 10-yard, just little 10-yard pass, you know, nothing major, and they're just going to kill the Eagles' defense, and again, the offense is just going to kill, or the defense is just going to kill the Eagles' offense, too. Like, I don't see anyone, it's hard for me to see anyone coming out of the NFC besides the 49ers, because the 49ers have a great defense, they have a good offense. Now, the Eagles can do it. And in fact, like, it would be like this more so, but like, it's just I have a hard time. Like, I don't believe in the Eagles, especially when you got shut down and lost to the Commanders. So, and they had Jalen Hurts. They had Jalen Hurts out there on that field at home. They were at home, and they lost to the Commanders. I don't see them. You have Christian McCaffrey. I didn't even touch on Christian McCaffrey in the backfield, too. You know, he's another weapon for the Niners. It's like, okay, what are you going to do? You got run over by the you got run over by the Commanders. What are you going to do with Christian McCaffrey, Debo? You know, what are you going to do with these players? So, like, they can make a deep run. They're going to make a deep run. I think they'll make it to the NFC Championship game. But I don't believe that they can hang with the Niners. I don't think anyone can in the NFC. So, Cowboys, I think, will make the division round. You're a first-round exit, and then you're a first-round exit. I don't believe in, like, Seattle doesn't deserve there. But there should not be a 7 seed. No one deserves that 7 seed. The Packers, the Seahawks, and the Lions don't deserve it, in my opinion. So, like, they're there strictly because, like, it's just another seed they have to fill. So that kind of fills out the NFC. Again, I just want to kind of get rid of that. Talking a lot more about the Niners than I thought I would. But they're just the best team in the NFC right now. And Eagles fans are going to get mad. But, again, what are you going to do? The Niners are on a 10-game winning streak right now coming into the playoffs. Again, Eagles lost to the Commanders with Jalen Hurts. Now, again, probably Taylor Heineke's probably better than Brock Purdy, but the Niners are going to have more weapons on offense than the Commanders did. So, like, what? I don't see how any team in the NFC is going to make it past the Niners. I don't. And they're the second seed, so the only time they would have to go on the road is the Eagles. So it's just, you know, I don't see any team. It's just, the NFC is so bad this year. It's so bad. Dolphins, now, at the time recording this on Wednesday, again, I want to get this up Wednesday night, but I have other videos I have to get out. So this might go up Thursday. You know, it just sucks. Everything's ruined. The camera situation set me back an hour and a half. You know, I wasted a bunch of battery life trying to mess around with this crap too, so I'm charging my camera too, and I still have, you know, more stuff I want to record today. But we got information today. Tua's out. Oh my god, I'm on a rant right now. It's been a bad day. It's been a bad day, and it's only noon when I'm recording this. screw it. I'm going through the freaking phone. I don't give a crap anymore. But anyway. It's just some scammers anyway, most likely. Tua's gonna be out, so we don't even know if Teddy Bridgewater's gonna be starting. I don't even know the situation with that. I think, was it concussion or some other injury? So he might not even be starting. And then they play the Bills. The Bills in the wild card. So it's just, the Dolphins don't really deserve to be in the playoffs just because they're gonna get killed. Without Tua, they're not a good team in the playoffs. So I don't see it. Ravens, I think, will be a first-round exit. It appears that Lamar Jackson will not be playing. I got information today that, you know, he's kind of trending in the wrong direction so far. Now, again, I'm recording this on Wednesday, so Saturday could come around and maybe, you know, things have switched up and he's looking a lot better on, you know, Saturday. Because they don't have to play till Sunday, I believe. So, you know, maybe he's playing by then and maybe they can, you know, make a deep playoff run. Maybe they can beat the Bengals, but right now, the Bengals, to me, feel like another Super Bowl contender. And there's not a lot of them. And again, we're down to 14 teams. But I just, you know, the Bengals feel like a team to me that they just went through it last year. They just got to the Super Bowl last year. They know what it takes. They know what, you know, they need to do. You have to beat the Chiefs. You have to beat the Bills. You know, you have to beat some of these upper-tier teams in the AFC. But you are an upper-tier team, too. And, you know, I think they can do it. How crazy would it be to have another Niners-Bengals Super Bowl? Just like the 90s. Or was that the 80s? 80s, not, whatever. Point is, how crazy would that to have that again? Jags, I think the Jags can make it to the divisional round. And if they get lucky, maybe the AFC Championship game. But they face the Chargers. To me, I think this is a good matchup for the Jags. They're at home in Florida. It'll be nice and warm for them. They'll be used to the weather down there and whatnot. So, you know, I think the Jags kind of have a, you know, weather advantage, you know, a climate advantage. Now, obviously, the Chargers are from California, so it's warm there, too. But They play in a dome. It's not a real dome, but they're protected from the rain, even though the fans aren't. Because if you watch the TCU in Georgia, they showed. Oh, I saw a clip online. I didn't watch the game, but I saw a clip online of rain was coming in sideways through that stadium. So you a $1 billion stadium and you can't protect the fans. Good job, NFL. You're so amazing. God, I love the NFL, man. But you know, this is gonna be, you know, probably a little more humid than what it is in California right now. I mean, they're going through, they have a bunch of rain and whatnot coming through there too. So, you know, I don't think it's supposed to be raining. I think it's supposed to be, you know, probably 70s or something like that, with humidity down in Florida. So I think the Chargers are at a disadvantage weather-wise, climate-wise. And I think this is a good matchup for the Jags. I think they can make it, you know, past the wild card round. And again, like I said, if they get lucky, maybe they make it to the AFC Championship game. I don't know. We'll see what that looks like when we get to the division round, if they're still in it. But if the cards fall right, I think there's a possibility they can make a deep playoff run. So, and then the Chiefs, you know, I mean, it's Patrick Mahomes. I think we'll just put him up there. They can make it. They've been through this many times. You know, it's your competition is the Bengals, is the Bills. You know, you don't really have anything else to really worry about in the AFC. You know, you have the one seed, so you have the bye, which, again, Eagles do too, but it's just, I'm not super sold on the Eagles when you have to face a good team. So, and yes, I mean, they lost to, you know, the Cowboys with Minshew out there, but they also beat the Cowboys when Cooper Rush was out there, so it kind of cancels out. So, yeah, you know, but they both, well, at least the second game was pretty high scoring. I forget what the score was for the first game, but, you know, pretty high scoring for that second game there. Bucks, I mean, they could beat the Bucks. I keep getting back on the Eagles. I'm trying to explain why I'm not, you know, I don't think the Eagles can make it to the Super Bowl. But it's just, you know, Chiefs, I think, have a better shot just because the Niners have the best defense in the playoffs this year. Bengals, I think, have a decent decent defense, but I think that they can get killed. You can, you know, if you have a good enough defense to, you know, slow down their offense, which is, I mean, that offense can be kind of hard to slow down. But if you're able to, I mean, you can do a shootout with the Bengals. The Bills have showed that, hey, like, they can struggle. They can, you know, the Patriots were in that game. What was it, 21-21 at half? Like, you have a team like the Patriots who didn't even make the playoffs who were essentially in a shootout in the first half against the Bills. So it's like, you know, the Chiefs' offense can do that. You want a shootout? You can get a shootout. And it's just, can the Chiefs' defense hold off the opposing team's offense? Maybe, depending on the day. It's any given Sunday. So, you know, I think they can make it. But at the same time, I mean, they couldn't, you know, make it to the AFC Championship game and get knocked out too. So, I mean, I'm going to leave them up here. But, you know, to me, like, you got a better QB than the Eagles. You know, you still have some pretty good weapons. You know, I'm not, the defense for the Kansas City, I feel like, has always kind of gone under the radar. I feel like they've not always been, you know, super amazing top five defense. But they've been good enough for the past couple years where it's like, hey, like, they make a playoff run. So, you know, you're not making the Super Bowl every year, but you're still making a run in the playoffs. So, you know, that's, like, the Eagles defense is good. I'm not going to deny that. But, you know, there's been teams that have been able to shred them. Teams have been able to beat them. Again, the Cowboys game was a shootout. Now, again, it was Gardner Minshew and not Jalen Hurts. Any given Sunday, though, it could be Dak Hurts. And you could be doing the shootout again in Philly. So, I don't know. It's just, you know, I'm not sold on either one of the one seeds this year. I still feel like the Bills or the Bengals deserve it more. But, you know, I would totally love a Bengals-Bills AFC Championship game. Totally love that. I would totally love Eagles-Niners NFC Championship game. You know, I'm totally would be okay with that stuff. But power rankings-wise, like, the Niners are probably the best team. And then I think I would do that. I think I would do Bills, Bengals, Chiefs. Probably in that order. So, Yeah, and then I think I would probably do that. I think I would probably do that. I mean, the Giants are like right on the edge of this. They're right on the edge for me. And then again, these I don't think the Seahawks or the Dolphins aren't gonna do anything in the playoffs. So for now, like the video, share the video around, don't forget to subscribe. Let me know down below who's making the Super Bowl. Who do you have ranked as the number one team? Who's the worst team? I feel like it's probably people are gonna say Dolphins, Seahawks for the worst team in the playoffs. Who do you want? Who do you think I should have moved up? Who do you think I should have moved down? I know people are going to be upset at the Jags because they're so high. But again, I think the Chargers are a perfect matchup for them. I think they can make it to the division round. And if things shake up right, you can make it and your ceiling is AFC Championship game. I don't think they're making the Super Bowl. But I already signed out. Again, don't forget to subscribe. And I'm out of here. Peace.